This is the continuation of our second part, exploring gas giant collisions across different simulators. Today, we're testing what happens when a small asteroid hits a gas giant. While some commented that planet collisions aren't possible in Solar Smash, I'd love to hear from those who still play it today. It would be amazing to see Solar Smash with a PC version and expanded features. I really appreciate its graphics quality despite being a mobile game. I'm currently using an emulator, though I'm having some trouble with screen rotation. Oh, look at that. Neptune automatically generated its rings when I created it. Let's observe the collision quality, though I'm keeping my expectations modest. I need to manually move Jupiter toward Neptune. Seems like Jupiter's a bit shy. It's a beautiful disaster. There's the collision. Boom! Did Neptune get destroyed? Interesting. Jupiter grew slightly after colliding with Neptune, while Neptune transformed into gas. Let's check if Jupiter shows any effects. Yes, Jupiter definitely took some damage from that Neptune collision. Now, let's switch to everyone's classic favorite, My Pocket Galaxy. I've been experimenting with this game to test its planet and star capacity, and surprisingly, there seems to be no limit. Just watch how everything interacts. These mobile space simulators are truly remarkable, though we probably won't see truly realistic ones anytime soon. You know why. The physics in this game are quite unusual, I must say. I tried an experiment placing stationary stars with 10 orbiting planets each. For our gas giant collision test, we'll use the solar system preset. The graphics are decent, though not extraordinary. Here comes Jupiter. Getting Jupiter close to Neptune was quite challenging. Watch this rather amusing collision. Looking at all five simulators we've tested, each one shines in its own way. They're all fantastic, except for Space Sim, which is simply in a class of its own. These mobile simulators really brought joy to our childhood,